YouTube, what's up? We are still outside. I'm trying to find my way home, to be honest, but we are at the sea currently. It is getting pretty cloudy, so we need to get back in. Today, we are going to talk about balancing updates in the game. There is actually 3 updates I want to talk about, and those are gonna be changing some of my videos and how you farm specific stuff, especially vouchers. So let's get into it. If you like the video. If you're here for the second time, please subscribe as well, and I will see you next time. Alright, so we are in the Discord in the balance changelog, and there is actually more stuff than what we have here. We have the tokens changing right now. I think I'm gonna give you my honest opinion about them. Sleep and freeze getting removed is great. To be honest, I feel like the biggest problem is end your tokens always. I'm not really have any issues with those not getting removed, although I do have an issue with them overall. But this is what's getting me, quote-unquote. So it says, it's still useful for catching mons with insane amount of HP bars, or no, boss bars later, waves, can have just slightly more in your favor now. Like, okay, first, if you are late into endless, or even early, to be honest, you are gonna have master balls. So this excuse here does not matter. Like, please remove those tokens. They are actually useless. Alright? Bosses having shields is just annoying in itself. Just get rid of them. But it might come later on, alright, with the endless rework. Or at least I hope they do. Now, with the removal of sleep and freeze and the nerf of recovery tokens, the sturdy only quote-unquote strat is getting okay again. We still have some berries issues. Of course, we need to micromanage more. It's still an issue. I believe you can still play it, for sure. But there is actually another problem that we're going to talk later on that comes with this. Actually, since we are in it, we might as well talk about it right now. There is a new update. It was pushed yesterday at 5 p.m. So we just need to find it. It was the Based Luck Encounter, which is the title of the video, I'm assuming. There you go. So here, yesterday at 5 p.m., we had this push from this guy, Brainfog. It is luck-based encounter. So what this means is that the higher your luck, the easier it is to find boss Pokemons. And if it's easier to find boss Pokemons, it's gonna be easier to find legendaries, right? So that's the push. And it is actually an issue as well when it comes to to endless in general, because what you want to do at highest floors to not really lose too much time or to have an easier time, quote-unquote, you would want to stop, you know, quote-unquote stop, to kill one bar Pokemon, so non-bosses, to farm those extra berries, or to farm those Master Balls if you need them. So you basically stop, you know, to farm those items in the shop. Now, with the base luck encounter, so don't get me wrong, it is a good change. Now, with your luck, you're gonna have, if you have higher luck, you're gonna get more bosses. So there is actually a goal in farming luck later on if you don't have a good luck early on, but it might as well be an issue. So there is a lot of ups and a couple of downs, but that's part of the game, right? Overall, you're just getting more legendaries, and that's very nice. After that, so recovery and healing are gonna be nerfed. So recovery and status heal tokens, those are gonna be nerfed. They nerfed all the status condition token as well, which is nice. And so all of this makes the sturdy strat only. So if you're not using Purifying Salt or Poison Heal, those are actually better now, right? So they are basically going up one tier if you check my tier list. I still don't like the Endure tokens. I mean, I have nothing against them. If they don't want to remove them for now, it's okay. But like, don't say this, okay? This is not it. Like, insane amount of bars, letter waves, who cares? You have Master Balls, right? Okay, classic change. So there is no more dual battle with champion for now. They are currently disabled. And every single champion teams have been adjusted, which now they actually have mega Pokemons. I haven't played classic since this change here because I've been busy doing my tier list. But I think this is just making classic harder for no reason. So some people like it, some people dislike it. Do I like it? I don't really care, to be honest. I feel like the champion is a joke most of the time, or the Elite Four is a joke most of the time. I think the only issue in this game was IV. The rest of it was a joke. Now, we are getting to the new change when it comes to vouchers, in general. I made a video a couple of days ago talking about the best way to farm vouchers. I think doing Zacian Rush is still the best way to go about it. Actually, it's probably very close. The voucher now was moved to Great Tier, right? So the it was yellow by default, so it was moved down to Great Tier, which is the blue tier, right? It's dependent on how healthy your team is kept up, which is an issue lately. Then we have the Voucher Plus moved down to Rock Tier, which is the red tier. And now they are actually saying it here because most people did not know about this one as well. But the weight is going to be adjusted based on your rerolls. Which means if you do not get a Voucher or a Voucher Plus in the first 3 rerolls, you don't need to reroll for them specifically. So later on, if you are just running away or killing easy Pokemons to get more Vouchers, you can just reroll 3 times and then move on. That's what you should do. Then of course, we have Voucher Premium now in the Master Tier, only in Classic, so those Premium Vouchers are not in Endless, but they are still given to you when you defeat Eternatus, right? So it says here, overall, be an increase of total Vouchers in all mods, especially in Classic. This is not true, to be honest. I think doing Zacian Rush with good luck, you can have some shinies left and right when you farm ribbons specifically for Classic. Good if you can bring some luck and to have a good enough luck to get those Voucher Premium. So if you can get them right, and you have on top of it all the ribbons. I truly believe that Gym Leader should give 1 if you defeat them for the second time, but I believe that the Elite Four should give 5 and the Champion should give 10. Just because that's the end of Classic, right? So 5 and 10, and then you would have all the rebounds plus the 10 at the end. It would be so much better. Like doing Classic for farming Vouchers outside of Zacian Rushing, it would be better just for normal teams. Like a normal run takes 2 hours, I think, on average, if you have a normal team with no legendaries. For 2 hours, like going to the Elite Four and winning against them, giving maybe like 30 Vouchers, right? So 5 times 4 plus 10, that would be 30 eggs, plus the completion at the end, so that's 10 plus like 5 times 5, so that's 35, 65. In total, that would be like 70 or 80 Vouchers, right? For one Classic run of 2 hours. Getting 80 eggs right now in Endless with those changes is insanely easy. So if you take a 250 round cycle in Endless, you get so many Vouchers. You get way more than 80 eggs. You get 30 by default just by defeating the 250 floors, but you get so many Vouchers in between as well. So I think changing, quote-unquote, the Voucher rewards for the Elite Four and the Champion would be a great addition to Classic on top of the ribbons. To be fair, I mean, this is going to be adjusted, of course, but we'll see in the future. So this is my take on it. I think Endless is probably the better way to go about it if you are not Zacian Rushing right now, which is like 40 minutes for a Classic run or 45 minutes. Of course, when you don't have any ribbons anymore, any ribbon Pokemons, Endless is always going to be the best way to go about it. And for candies, it's always going to be Classic, by the way. So there is no change about that one. There you go. Those are all the updates. I would say, I know, those updates have ups and downs. The fact that a lot of people were bitching about the tokens and the berries made this change. To be fair, I don't think it was planned, because as they said here, Endless token system is a dire need of replacement. Yes, until we have the Endless rework, they are nerfing token across the board. I like how they say gone entirely, no one liked them, no one likes injured tokens as well. Nobody does. That's gonna be it for me. I hope you guys are enjoying those changes as well. I made this video primarily because there was a lot of clarification to be made with the Voucher. I think it's way better in Endless now. And there was a clarification to be made about my last video and the tier list. So Sturdy only, quote-unquote, gets back in the can be played, but Poison Heal is still way better. Again, that's gonna be me. We're gonna stream later on. We're gonna finish the tier list. And my next video is gonna be a Gen 1 clear in Classic, then we might have the tier list, and after that we have an episode for the Endless walkthrough. Okay, well, see ya.